Here is a bucket held in position by four ropes. The goal is to find the tensions in each rope given the bucket weighs 10 pounds. First, label all points of interest, including the concurrent points B and C. Next, measure some angle. Now start at a point that has a known force. In this case, B will be the starting point. Create a free body diagram showing all forces applied to the steel ring at point B. Remember, ropes only take tension forces that pull on the ring. The line of action of these forces all pass through the concurrent point located at the center of the steel ring. Isolate these forces and drop everything else from the picture. Draw axes to reference the angle of the ropes. Axes are usually needed in statics. Now apply the equations of equilibrium. For tension A, draw the x and y components of the force. Remember, these components take place of the current force but do not change the reaction. Vector components are used in place of a force that isn't horizontal or vertical. Now we can see that the sum of the forces in the y direction must equal zero. Therefore, the y component of tension A has to equal 10 pounds. Knowing the y component of tension A, use a bit of trick to determine its magnitude using the given angle. Then calculate the x component of force tension A. Now we can see that tension C must be equal and opposite of the x component to maintain equilibrium. So tension C must equal 7 pounds. Both forces have been found, so it looks like we're done here. Let's go back to the system. The tension at point B pulls towards point C. But Newton's third law says for every action, there's an equal and opposite reaction. So the tension at point C must pull towards point B. To keep point C in equilibrium, tensions D and E must pull on point C as well. The angles are measured and we're ready to draw the free body diagram for point C. For tension D, draw the X and Y components of the force just like before. Using trig, write the equations relating the X and Y components to the tension D. Remember, the components of the force replace the tension vector without changing the overall reaction. Do the same for tension E. Now we'll sum the forces in the x direction to equal zero. Make the substitutions. There are two unknowns requiring two equations to solve, which comes from the other equilibrium equation. The trig that relates the x and y components will make the algebra possible and manageable. Let's solve the bottom equation for tension E and substitute it into the top equation. Rearrange the terms and solve for tension D. Substitute this to solve for tension E. Now substitute tension D and tension E to solve for its vector's components. Check the equilibrium. If the sum of the forces do not equal zero, there's a problem. These look balanced. These are the forces pointing on the rings by the tensions in the ropes. The ropes are tied to supports A, D, and E, which hold the 10-pound bucket in equilibrium. If you untied the rope at support A, you would need to pull 12.2 pounds upwards to hold the bucket in place. Always check the components of the external forces to ensure they satisfy the equilibrium equations. It's basically to check your answers. These X and Y components are okay. And that solves the entire problem.